John Mara and Steve Tisch did the right thing firing Tom Coughlin 2 years ago, and it was logical to promote rising star Ben McAdoo. It just hasnt worked out. Projecting whether an assistant can be a longtime successful coach in his first shot being a head coach is risky business. Bill Belichick bombed in 5 years in Cleveland. Bill Parcells was 3,121 in his first season with the Giants and was nearly fired. The Giants' humiliating loss to the Rams last week may have clinched McAdoo and GM Jerry Reese being fired at the end of the season. The loss to the previously winless 49ers on Sunday should have expedited the timetable to right now, but Mara issued a statement Monday saying this is still McAdoo's team, there's still 7 games remaining, which is way too long to sit back and keep getting smacked in the face. If this was the 14th week, Mara and Tisch could hang on tight and wait for the season to end. Belichick images Ben McAdoo is our head coach and has our support, Mara said, going on to say, at the end of the year, we will evaluate the 2017 season in its entirety and make a determination how to move forward. That's good news now for McAdoo and embattled GM Jerry Reese. Bad news for them on January 1st, the day after the season ends, and bad news for fans who hoped Mara would send shockwaves through his underachieving team by canning the coach once the play landed from San Francisco. If Mara changes his mind after another one or two more blowouts, McAdoo would walk away with the Giants' record. No coach in their history has lasted less than 2 seasons. Ray Hanley, who succeeded Parcells in 1991, is the only Giants coach who owns the dubious distinction of being let go after 2 turmoil-filled years. One reason coaches in the NFL rarely get fired mid-season: it's not baseball, it's impossible to bring in a candidate from the outside with his own system, and promoting an assistant rarely does much. Seth went a gap after the season, that's different. The Giants can make a run at Josh McDaniels or Sean Payton or John Gruden or Nick Saban. Just the fact that Mara felt compelled to issue a statement illustrates how the pressure is building in the organization. If the Giants completely implode in the next 2 weeks, who would take over the last 5 games? Offensive coordinator Mike Sullivan makes the most sense. He's a non-nonsense guy who will immediately have the support of Eli Manning, still the most important voice in the locker room. The results are not likely to get much better, but for a week or two, the locker room will be given a jolt. A new voice, Sullivan won't be telling stories about Frazier, the crazed lion, will get the players' attention. Getting rid of McAdoo now will convince the players that nobody's job is safe, forget about defensive coordinator Steve Spagnuolo. After last season's defensive resurgence, thanks to Reese's $200 million Band-Aid, Spags could have been assistant coach of the year. He was even positioning himself for another chance to be a head coach. But the defense started badly this year, blowing fourth-quarter leads in losses 3-5 to the Eagles, Bucks and Chargers, and has now gotten historically bad the last 2 weeks, giving up 82 points to the Rams and 49ers, coached by rookies Sean McVay and Kyle Shanahan. Howard Simmons, New York Daily News. Obviously, college coaches and NFL assistants are off-limits until the end of the season. That means waiting on McDaniels and perhaps making an attempt at Saban for the third time. Nobody other than a desperate out-of-work coach will take the job on an interim basis through the rest of the season, even though it would come with the promise of being interviewed after the season. If the Giants want Gruden, there is little chance he would want to inherit this mess mid-season and have it go on his record, although it would give him a head start evaluating the roster. Bill Cowher, who might have been the Giants' coach at various points if Coughlin was fired earlier, has not coached since 2006, loves working for CBS and living the New York lifestyle, and has been adamant he's not going to coach again. Rex Ryan be lots of fun, but trying to remain realistic here. He's not the Giants' style. They could get Jeff Fisher tomorrow. He was on the competition committee with Mara for many years, but only if they want to settle for a mediocre, overrated coach. Mike Shanahan is available but was bad in his last job in Washington. Mike Holmgren could have had the Jets job in 2015, but his wife didn't want to move east. Steven Senny firing McAdoo now or later won't impact the ultimate narrative of the season. It's gone way beyond disappointing and humiliating and is in the running for the all-time worst nightmare in the history of the Giants, which is now in its 93rd season going back to 1925. Of course, it's not the Giants' way to fire coaches in midseason. It's not anybody's way, really, except for the late Al Davis, who fired Joe Bugle and Art Shell after one season and Mike Shanahan and Lane Kiffin after 20 games. In-season changes rarely work. Rare exception, Jason Garrett was 53 in 2010 in Dallas after taking over for Wade Phillips, who was 17. The Giants have not fired a coach mid-season since 1976 when Bill Arnsparger was let go 7 games into his third season. The Giants were 0-7 and overall Arnsparger was 728. Leroy Andrews, in 1930, was the only other coach the Giants have ever released during the season. Jim Fassel preempted the Giants firing him after the 2003 season by announcing with 2 games remaining he would resign after the year. The Giants were 410 at the time. It allowed Fassel to take a victory lap of sorts. He lived off the 2000 Super Bowl appearance, and the Giants lost their final 2 games and hired Coughlin. Making a coaching change now would have sent a strong message from Mara and Tisch to Big Blue Nation. Their pain threshold has been reached, and even if it's just a cosmetic change, no more effective than reassigning the headsets, they are at least trying to salvage the last 2 months. McAdoo did win 11 games last year, but whatever magic he had is gone. Mara called it an extremely disappointing season, and while he appreciates the fans' unhappiness, nobody is more upset than we are. He had a chance to wake up his team by firing McAdoo, but passed, for now.